Ladies and gentlemen, we will begin in a moment. Please, let's do a little maintenance. If we have cell phones and pagers, please put them on vibrate. So we don't get up at this time.
say to them, you can count on me. There's a time, a need, a crisis, I'll be there. They've worked hard, they've studied, they've trained. They cross a threshold tonight, which they cannot return, for public service is something that is born into the heart of people who have that desire within them to serve others. So tonight, we lift them up to you. We ask you as they begin their careers to watch over them and protect them. May they stand tall and strong, and when the need arises, may they step forward. May they be the type of person that their brothers and sisters in law enforcement can count upon. May their integrity be firm and secure. May their character be unquestionable. May their bravery be unheard of and be that which is truly remarkable for others. So tonight, we ask your blessings upon this cadet class as they step forward, begin a new page in their life. Thank you for their families. Thank you for those that have stood by them for such a long time and enabled them to reach this point. Father, we commit them into your care. It's in the name of our Master we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Chaplain. I'm Lieutenant Colworth. I'm the training coordinator for the Sheriff's Office Training Academy. And on behalf of the Sheriff, Chief Deputy, and my captain, I'd like to welcome you to the 2009 class AO9 graduation ceremony. Before I begin, we need to recognize very important people. I'd like to recognize the Sheriff's Command Staff. Can you please stand? Thank you for showing up.
Ladies and gentlemen, is an outstanding group of men and women. I know that everyone's family and friends are here tonight. I'm very proud of each and every one of you for what you've been able to accomplish. So am I. With the oath of office you take tonight, you will now be in the public eye more than ever in your life. You will be held at a higher standard, and that's the way it should be. Starting tonight in your law enforcement career, everything you do will follow you years down the road. Especially should you ever decide that you want to be in public office. But it's very easy to do the right thing. I want to commend the academy staff for the fine job that they do every day for training the staff. For the outstanding job that they did with this graduating class. Congratulations to each one of you. And may God bless AO tonight. Thank you.
Thanks, Sheriff. Next, I would like to thank Dr. Buchanan for your assistance to this academy, making sure that we actually got this academy class off the ground and keep it going. So, to you, Dr. Buchanan, thank you. Next, I would like to introduce the president of the college, Dr. Austin Lane.
About you, how about another round of applause for these young men? I had the pleasure of attending several graduations that we have here at the college, and I'll tell you what, there are two graduations that you really have to keep it together. There was one I was caught totally off guard with, and that was the fire science graduation. And a few months back. The other graduation is you guys sit in front of me, and I'll go into a little detail of you shortly. But I tell you what, it is so refreshing to hear Sheriff Gage and the words that he just gave you about you being held to a higher standard. I totally agree with him 100%. I think Sheriff Gage and Captain Henderson and Lieutenant Culbert. And all the Montgomery County sheriffs that are here, all the employees that are here, I thank you so much for allowing us to be part of this partnership with you. There's so many folks that you know have stayed up late and have given you the pat on the back and told you that you can do well, and you did it. Starting with 27 and finishing with 26 and having a 100% pass rate is extremely impressive, very impressed. I also want to thank, and I don't want to talk to you to death here, but I want to thank again Dean Buchanan, Professor Stelter, and also our professor who came in with the bagpipes, Professor Livingston. If you could give them a round of applause. I really had a hard time thanking Dean Buchanan and Professor Stelter, and I want to tell you why. When I got here a couple of months ago, it's been a year on the job now, when I got here back in the summer, all they could talk about was this Montgomery County Sheriff's Academy that we had here, how great it was. And I felt pretty first class. Professor Stelter, if you know what kind of car he drives, he picked me up in a blue Jaguar. So I thought, well, this is first class. I'm going to Montgomery County Sheriff's Office. Now, you got to be careful about how you get in the car with people. You got to really be careful. I thought I was going to an executive suite over at Sheriff Gage's office, and he was going to sit on some couches and all these kinds of things. And I walked in to a couple of gates and a bunch of officers with guns and you name it. And so I was automatically a little nervous. Now, I don't have a record or anything. I hadn't done anything wrong. But I was really nervous, and I thought, you know what, I'm going to be able to get out of here. And sure enough, I didn't see those offices, but I saw a couple of jail cells, and I saw a couple of folks who, I guess, had gotten into some trouble. They didn't take the high road there, Sheriff. And so they were in there for some things that they did wrong. And so in all seriousness to the folks who are here, I know you read the paper like I do. I know you hear these stories about how these young men and women put their lives on the line every single day. And when I got into that office, not an office, it was a jail, I really felt like also the thing that you do well is you hide a lot of the darkness that goes on out here. You hide a lot of the things that would scare people half to death. When I heard about some of the stories of the folks who were actually in those facilities, I really thank God that I stayed on the right track and that I did take the high road. I also have to admit that I don't know that I can do what you do or what you're going to do or what many of you have already done for us. So I do want to personally thank you for keeping our community safe. I want to thank you for keeping my kids safe, my family safe. I know there are things you do at all hours of the night and in the morning, and you do it for us. And so I want to thank all of you for the work you're going to do, the work you've been doing, and for all of you who are here with your loved ones, this ought to be the best time in your life. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. White. Next, we have our commencement address by District Attorney Brett Bailey.
Cynic among you would say that 26 out of 27 people graduating may mean that the course and the study was easy. And I'd say take a look at the quality of these cadets, and that'll tell you, look at the quality of the instructors, look at the quality of the command staff. That'll tell you, don't be a cynic, that'll tell you that these are some of the best and some of the brightest that Montgomery County has to offer. That's all. Words are for you, you cadets. The oath that you take to protect and serve is not merely a contract with your employer, Montgomery County Sheriff's Department, or Sheriff Tommy Gage. It's a solemn vow. A vow's bond can be broken not only with your words, but your deeds. So I'm going to spend my few minutes with you issuing each and every one of you a challenge. And it's easy. I want you to master three things. Number one, freedom. Number two, authority. Number three is responsibility. Freedom. As you enter into your career as a deputy, you'll have the freedom and the flexibility that comes with a single-man unit. That freedom can be spent in chasing new leads, meeting the community, working on reports, and in general, continuing to mold yourself into a better officer. And the alternative, squander that freedom, and you'll find yourself dragging out calls, looking for a honey hole to hide in, not responding quickly to the next one in queue or writing bad reports, and in general becoming part of the problem instead of part of the solution. That freedom can lift you up for promotion or play out like an albatross around your neck. Only you can decide how you're going to use yours. Authority. My personal belief is that learning to master authority is critical. It's often said you really don't know how much authority you have until you refuse to exercise it. As an officer, in given circumstances, you even have the authority to take someone's life without the benefit of a trial or an appeal. You can squander that authority on a traffic stop and become abusive and belligerent. Or expand your authority by keeping your emotions in check and allowing the system to function as it should. Don't squander your authority that the state of Texas and its grand citizens have given you by being petty or abusive. Enhance your standing and the standing of your agency by becoming a professional and a beacon for peers and the general population. Lastly is responsibility. I don't have the eloquence of words to describe in flowery detail how society should feel and function, and what high-esteemed citizens should hold their local law enforcement. But I am a son of law enforcement. I felt the heat rise from the pavement as you stood while directing traffic. I've seen the red eyes of my dad as he worked on the case that stretched into its 30th hour. And I saw the pangs of guilt, and I'm esteemed in you as a Mission Boys baseball game or your daughter's dance recital, and it's going to happen. So when it comes to being responsible to your department, your sheriff, your classmates, your family, and all those who you are charged with safekeeping, ask yourself, are you completing your shift, or are you just trying to get through it? Are you working these cases, or just shifting the paper? If the answer is that you just count down the days, or it's another day, another dollar, then you're not being responsible to your fellow officers. You don't want to be the weakest link in that chain of law enforcement whose actions tarnish your entire department. And remember, you came to this. You came to this willingly, not like lambs, but like lions. At its best, in my opinion, law enforcement is a calling, and its officers are disciples of the Penal Code and the Code of Criminal Procedure. You're not to be renegades or rogues pursuing your own agenda. So easy. It's so easy. Three things. My challenge to you is to make each day until the last day that you lay down your badge and gun something that you will be remembered by, knowing that you mastered freedom, authority, and responsibility. Remember your vow and live up to your challenge. Let your actions be a salute to your fellow classmates, not just in words, but in deeds. Thank you.
Starfish he heaved back into the ocean, and we too can make a difference. somehow, someway, it matters to someone. I want to take this opportunity to personally thank each and every one of the 809 cadets. It was an honor to learn, sweat, and bleed with each of you. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank all the families, friends, significant others, wives, of all the cadets. Thank you for your support. Cadets, on your feet. On behalf of the entire 809 cadet class, I would like to take this opportunity as well to give a special thanks to Sheriff Tommy Gage, Chief Deputy Randy McDaniel, Captain Rand Henderson, Lieutenant Ken Colbert, Corporal Tommy Overstreet, Corporal Burt Ward, Corporal Shane Albritton, Corporal Lonnie Odishi, along with Mrs. Dana Haynes and Mrs. Ann Young, and all the many instructors who aided us in our training throughout the past 10 months. Cadets, take your seats. At this time, I would like to introduce the Vice President of the 809, Robert Missel, for the presentation of the guidelines.
Since early times, the guidon has been used by units in combat as a rallying point in the smoke, dust, noise, and confusion of battle. Although no longer carried into combat, the guidon remains a great source of pride for the unit and signifies the unit itself. The guidon stands out in front of the formation and leads the unit. On either side, see the guidelines that represent the Montgomery County Sheriff's Office Law Enforcement Academy. And it's a tradition that we take the streamer from the cadet's guidon that resides at the academy and transfer it to the Sheriff's Office guidon, symbolizing the graduation of our class. At this time, I'm going to have the cadet class president transfer the streamer from cadet class A09 to the sheriff's streamer. Post. Got it.
Thank you, cadets, for that fine ceremony. Next, I'd like to call to stage Captain Henderson.
Good evening. It's my honor tonight to present the recognition and awards for the cadets who have proven the outstanding accomplishments throughout the course of the academy this session. The first to be class valedictorian, Cadet Robert T. Missel. Top Gun, Cadet Clayton L. Simonson. Cadet Driving Award, Cadet Eric P. Wagner.
Yeah. Cadet Cody Bryant.
Dustin Pugh.
step and heading step to the stage, please. Before we leave, I have to thank these people to my right, the Training Academy staff. Without these dedicated individuals, this program would not go as smooth as it did. I'd like to thank the registrar, Dana Haynes,